Is she saying double D double die? Because that's what I'm saying. Hello everyone, my name is Sarah and welcome back to The Literary Life. So I found this quiz online from SparkNotes and it's basically a quiz about what book I should read next because Lord knows I need another suggestion of a book to read instead of just sticking to my TBR pile. Alright, I have my laptop here, so let's just get into it. Do you need new books to read? Do you have a stack of unread books in your room that you keep meaning to get to, but instead you're online looking for new books to read? Yeah? Gosh, how'd they know? That's okay, we won't judge you. Ugh, I like how they said, that's okay, we won't judge you, but you already did. The shade is so real. Ugh. Okay. Question number one, pick a genre. So we have sci-fi, crime and mystery, teen fiction, historical fiction, or fantasy. I think I'm gonna go for fantasy just because I feel like all the other stuff are great, but once you get into a good fantasy book, oh my god, it's the best thing ever. It's the best thing ever, hands down. Question number two, how do you feel about romance in your books? I'm not all about it, but that doesn't mean I hate it either. I can take it or leave it. I like it when it's done. Yeah, I like it when it's done right. How is romance overused? It's just, it's a thing that happens. Okay, whatever. I like it when it's done right, which means not cringy. I would know a lot about cringiness. Question number three. I like my main characters to be funny, bold, relatable, conflicted, or clever. All of those things. I would say relatable, but why isn't that diverse? So that's out of the running. Conflicted. I'm gonna go for clever, just because what I can't stand is when the characters are just imbeciles. Like when they literally see the answers right in front of them, and they are too stupid to figure it out. That makes me so mad. So I think I'll go for clever, because I feel like with clever you can be funny, you can be bold, like it all kind of goes underneath the umbrella that is clever. Question number four, pick a popular YA novel. Harry Potter, The Giver, Perks of Being a Wallflower, Hunger Games, or Fault in Our Stars. I'm gonna go for Hunger Games, not because it's my favorite out of the few, but because when I read Hunger Games, I literally marathoned it for an entire night. I stayed up the entire night and I went to school the next day. But I wasn't mad, you know, like I loved it in that moment and then people have ruined it for me. But that's a whole different story. So yeah, Hunger Games. Question number five, what was the last book you read? Oh no, I don't remember. Ooh, no. Do they mean like fully read or just like touched, dabbled? I'm gonna go with the last book that I like touched, and that is City of Bones, because I've been trying to get into the whole Mortal Instruments thing that everyone is loving, so something popular. Yeah, and it's been sitting on my shelf for a while. We're gonna go with something popular though. Everyone knows the Mortal Instruments, literally everyone, and their grandmother, and their great-grandmother. Like, it's just, it's a household name, that book. Question number six, what do you look for in a book? I want a book that's unique and different, book with a happy ending, makes me think, makes me laugh, makes me cry. Happy ending, overrated. Makes me think, yeah, but it's like I don't want to have to work too hard. That makes me sound so lazy. I think I'm gonna go with a book that's unique and different, because with books that I read, I usually want to read them because the premise or what I've heard about them is different and is unique from all the rest of the things that, like, you know, all the regular books have. So, unique and different. You got Illuminate by Amy Kaufman and Jay Kristoff. Wow. You know what's really awesome? I read this book already. I guess the quiz is right in saying that, like, it's a book I should read because it's a book I have read. It's a great book, honestly, Illuminae. If you haven't read it, you're living under a rock. So figure out that situation and then go get the book because it's incredible and you will not regret it. Trust me, it's such a good book. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go back through and I'm gonna answer the quiz with my second top answers, and then we'll see if I get a different book to read. I don't know. Let's go for it. Okay, you got M or F by Lisa Papadimitriou and Chris Tibetz. Okay, first of all, I massacred her last name. I'm very sorry, Lisa. Told in alternating points of view, love that, between Frankie and Marcus, M or F, oh, Frankie, Marcus, duh, is hilarious. Heartfelt retelling of Serrano. I don't know what Serrano is. Not off to a good start. Okay, that takes place in the modern day. When Marcus learns about Franny's new crush, Jeffrey, he makes it his mission to set them up. The problem, Franny's too scared to talk to Jeffrey, even online. So Marcus, who's better at this sort of thing, lends her a hand, such a nice friend. But drama unfolds when Marcus, who's gay, realizes he might have a crush on Jeffrey too. Ah! And he's not entirely sure Jeffrey doesn't return the interest. Oh my god. I'm gonna read that. You guys will be seeing a review of M or F by Lisa, last name I really mess up, and Chris Tibetz. Okay. All right, so that's gonna be it for this quiz and today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.